You probably filled out a table or made a chart about this in class. The properties of water. And these things don't seem like they should be that complicated, right? Water's not that hard. It's everywhere. But year after year, I see this same thing tripping students up. So let's keep that from happening to you. Hi, I'm Sarah, and I'm your other biology professor. Let's talk about the properties of water. There are several properties of water that make it important for living things. But in this video, we're just going to talk about two of them, the sticky ones, adhesion and cohesion. Up in the corner, I'll link to videos where I talk about some of the other properties in case you want to review those as well. Now, based on past students, these two properties themselves aren't super complicated. We're going to review them anyway. But instead, the biggest place that students would get into trouble here is that they'd simply mix them up. Let's start with cohesion. Cohesion is the tendency of water to attract other water molecules. Hopefully, you remember that water is a polar molecule, and the negative pole of one water molecule will attract the positive poles of nearby water molecules. Now, if you're thinking, okay, that just sounds like hydrogen bonding, you're spot on. Water has cohesive properties because of hydrogen bonding. That's what makes it sticky. Water molecules tend to stick together. But water also has a tendency to be attracted to other substances, and that's adhesion, right? Adhesive. Think glue, tape. You're sticking something to something different. Water is polar. So, what sorts of substances would it be attracted to? Probably other polar substances, right? Or charged surfaces as well. Let's look at an example to separate these two out a little bit more. Here, the little red dots are super simplified water molecules. Imagine you've got some body or container of water. It doesn't matter how big it is. It could be a lake, it could be a glass of water. Well, in that body of water, the water molecules are surrounded by other water molecules, interacting with them through hydrogen bonding. And that's going to cause the water molecules to be pulled in all directions. But if we look specifically at the molecules at the surface of the water, these molecules, not surrounded on all sides, are only being pulled by their neighbors from the side and downwards by their neighbors underneath them. No hydrogen bonds pulling them up. This results in the water at the surface being very, very dense. Those molecules are held together super tight. And that allows the water at the surface to resist being broken. This is surface tension. So, is this an adhesive property or is this a cohesive property? Cohesive, right? We've only got water interacting with other water molecules here. Water sticking to other water, that's cohesion. So, this is that property that allows insects to walk on top of water, for example. I really meant for him to be cute, but I tried. I think that the big reason that cohesion and adhesion get mixed up is because in so many examples, they actually occur together. So I've got a little test tube over here to emphasize this. When adhesion is stronger than cohesion, you can get a meniscus. You can see that on the sides as water is sort of climbing up the sides of the container. Adhesion greater than cohesion means that water is more attracted to the surface of our test tube than it is to the other water molecules. So it's sort of maximizing its surface contact, its interactions with the glass. Do we still have cohesion here? Sure, the water molecules are still interacting and still sort of being sticky with each other down below the surface. How do you think this tube would look different if instead
cohesive forces were stronger than adhesive ones. It might look something like this, where you have more of a convex meniscus sort of bulging out at the top. You'd see this with something like mercury, which is super, super cohesive. But let's get back to water. That's what this is all about. If we took our tube and we shrunk the diameter of it, made it really, really, really narrow, we can see something called capillary action, where water is sort of climbing up our tube, our capillary, against gravity, using the force of adhesion, the attraction to the walls of that container. And as it's climbing up the walls, it's also pulling up water molecules beneath it. That's cohesion. This is actually part of how water molecules move up a tree trunk from the roots, transporting water all the way up to the leaves. Both adhesion and cohesion at play.
Feeling a little bit better about the properties of water? I hope so. If so, give the video a like and share it with your friends so that other students can get a little bit of help with this topic as well. It can be a little tricky sometimes. Be sure to check out my website, where I will be posting new videos as frequently as I can get them made. And I will see you next time for some more biology. Cheers.